Welcome to the Coleraine Presbyterian Church. Jesus said, "Let the little children come to me, and do not hinder them, for the kingdom of heaven belongs to such as these." This morning we look forward to our children's program as they present the story of the birth of Jesus. Please join me in the call to worship. Let our spirit magnify our God.
Let our spirits rejoice in God our Savior.
God has looked upon us with favor.
God is doing great things for us.
God comes to bring justice to the earth.
We welcome God's word and let us join in.
Please open your hymnals to number 143, Infant Holy, Infant Lowly.
Let them know that the Messiah was coming. We have our practice at 6 o'clock this Wednesday, and we'd like as many kids to be involved as possible. The kids are going to be, the young ones are going to be dressed as angels in white, and when they process down the aisle, they will be lit up, and it's going to be really neat. The older ones are going to be shepherds and et cetera, and so it's going to be, I think, a very beautiful Christmas Eve program. So our practice is Wednesday, and we're going to meet at 6 o'clock and go over things. Then we are going to have a joint meeting of the Board of Deacons and the Board of Elders at 6 o'clock on Thursday. So that will be Thursday. It's going to be a busy week. We will have a service here Christmas Eve morning, the 24th, our regular service, and then 7 p.m. will be our Christmas Eve service. Is there any other announcements? Anyone else? Yes, Bill.
Not related to the church, but my wife lost her time with that between here and the sanctuary.
There is a diamond necklace somewhere. If you see it,
it's a heart.
It has a heart on it. So if you see it, pick it up and give it to Bill and Nancy.
Joe.
Yes.
We're going to do a stewardship.
Short stewardship meeting after church during the fellowship time. Okay. Anything else?
I just want to mention that those food boxes for the needy will be going out this afternoon.
Okay.
I haven't put the food in there, so if there is anybody who hasn't notified me, let me know before I get out of here today. Please.
All right.
Thank you.
So those food boxes are going out today. Yes, it is. A lot of smiling faces of grandmas and grandpas, and you and I are a couple. All right, then. Yeah. Ready for our praise song?
So our praise song this morning is just going to be a traditional hymn. Sort of according to the nation with the children's program and the birthday party for Jesus, one small child, as we get closer in preparing for our Christmas Eve service.
Small child in the land of a thousand, one small dream of a savior tonight, one small.
competition. This is for the Christmas Joy offering. There are special envelopes in our bulletins. Why is the Christmas Carol, What Child Is This, so meaningful to us? Yes, it links a beautiful tune with inspiring words, but it is more than that. It is in the vision behind and beyond the tune and text where we find the deeper truths. When we sing, What Child Is This?, we sing of a flesh and blood human, born under the most vulnerable of conditions. We sing of Emmanuel, God with us. When we sing, What Child Is This?, we are reminded of the infants born in our own life stories, our congregational communities, and beyond, down the street and around the world. The world so bring him incense, gold, and myrrh, remind us not only of the gifts the Magi offered to the baby Jesus who is the perfect gift, but also how we can support those whom God loves with our own gifts, with the words, the babe, the son of Mary, we sing of all those who are vulnerable and in need, which includes those who receive support from the Christmas Joy Offering. The Christmas Joy Offering supports retired ministers and church workers and their families through the assistance program of the Board of Pensions as they face medical and emergency costs. And we just want to thank you for your generous gifts to the Christmas Joy Offering and your ongoing prayers for all those who support it. Let us pray. Loving God, we thank you for the good news of Christmas and Jesus, the perfect gift. As we hasten to bring him laud with loving hearts, bless our gifts and bless our givings to the Christmas Joy Offering. Amen.
The third Sunday in Advent reading comes from the book of Isaiah, chapter 9, 6 and 7. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the greatness of his government and peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. Throughout Scripture, Jesus has been referred to by many names. Isaiah called Jesus four names that not only give us a glimpse of the power of Jesus, but also encompass the truth of the Trinity. Wonderful Counselor is the Holy Spirit. He convicts and guides and speaks to God on our behalf when we are too grieved to find words on our own. Mighty God, have you considered how mighty our God is? He is all-powerful and knowing, all-seeing. He is everywhere all at once and right here with us. Everlasting Father, from the beginning of time till time as we know it is no more and beyond, God will be our Father and Jesus will be at his side. Prince of Peace, Jesus brings a kind of peace that the world can't understand. As many have discovered, true peace is only found in Jesus, our wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God and Everlasting Father. Heart was troubled after discovering that Mary, his betrothed, was with child. But then an angel of the Lord visited him and said, "She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." Matthew 1:21. That name, the name Jesus, is above all names.
Knowing that we are flawed human beings living in a fallen world, we come humbly before a holy God. It is by God's grace, through the Son, that we can be restored and renewed. Please join me in the prayer of confession. We confess
to you, O God, and before one another, that we have sinned. We have looked at our relationship with you as one that gives us privilege and special status. We so easily forget that you have called us to serve others and bring your reign of justice and peace to its fulfillment. Forgive us our blindness and self-centered ways, and empower us with your Spirit to enter once more into the way of Jesus and serve the good of others. Amen.
Please take a moment for your own personal prayer of confession.
Touch. touch their lives. I pray for anyone who needs guidance this morning, Lord, who needs to see that light upon a clear path down which they need to go. Lord, we pray that you would shine your light and guide anyone, Lord, who is in need of your guidance. Lord, thank you for this opportunity to pray for these people. I want to lift up Lynn to you right now. We thank you for her recovery, but we pray that you keep on moving her in the right direction to that full recovery. So bless her and watch over her life. We pray for these other people. So many people are battling cancer. We lift them up to you, Lord. Buddy and Ashley, Sam and Jackie. We think of Marjorie, Jessica, Dan, Sandra. We lift up Kim and Dina to you, and Philip, Tom and Susie. Lord, as they go through their treatments, may they be effective. Be with Denny and Gail. Watch over Ron and John, Jack and Marlene. Be with Donna and young Leo. Watch over Karen. Lord, if they are cancer-free right now, sustain their healing. Keep your hand of healing upon them. And Lord, we pray for all the other people who are battling different health problems. We think of Sophia and Cole and all of our young ones. Watch over each and every one of them. Be with Donna and Nancy. Continue to be with Luga and the heart problems he's having. Watch over Randy. We lift him up to you. Be with Sue and Bill. We continue to pray for Bill Bowling and Patrick's dad, Mr. McCormick. Watch over Dana. Be with Jack. Continue to watch over Dorothy and Bill. Our friend Jane Whitecutt and her health. Lord, we think of Bruce and Ron. Shayna and Bill. Daisy and her health problems. Young Hazel, we lift up to you. Ron, who's battling COPD. And we pray for young Harrison and his recovery. Continue to watch over Lisa and Jason. Think of Gunner and Garrett, John and Chuck. Be with Carol battling Parkinson's, Vicki. Continue to be with Bill. We're glad to see him here this morning, and we continue to pray for his victory in this battle he's in. Watch over Marty and Maggie. Be with Jack, who was Adam Gunn's son, and be with their family. Watch over Wayne and James. Continue to be with Raymond and George. We think of Joyce having kidney problems. Lift up that to you. Olivia battling muscular dystrophy. We think of Troy and Carolyn. Kay after this auto accident. Judy and Ken. George, who is recovering from a stroke. Be with Les, Trevor, and Tori. Continue to be with Jim Bolden's grandchildren after that school bus accident. Watch over them and help them through this trauma. We continue to lift up Tim, Mike, who's having a lung problem, and these unspoken prayers from Cheryl, Debbie, Jane, Patrick, and Mitch. You know the circumstances, and we pray that you would guide and lead through each and every family, that you would shine your light upon their path. So Lord, we thank you for all of these people, and now Lord, we pray for this world that we're living in. There are wars and rumors of wars. There is destruction and death happening around the world, but we pray for peace. We pray, Lord, that people would open up their eyes and understand how you, working through their lives, can shine that light of peace into this dark world. We pray, Lord, that we would begin to understand the peace that our Lord Jesus offers to us. It is a peace that the world cannot take away. Lord, we pray for our military people around the world and ask that you would protect them and bring them home safely to their families. And now we pray together the prayer that the Son of God taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. This time, let us honor the Lord with the giving of our tithes, our gifts, and our offerings. So help us to know how to give and bless what we give. Help us to be channels of blessing so that your goodness flows through us and out to others. Bless this church and its ministry. And I thank you for all these good people in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated.
Christmas fills our hearts with joy as we think of gifts, lights, and holiday spirit. But remember, Christmas means something more. It is the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ, so let us travel back to Bethlehem and share the story of his birth.
Thank you. that while they were there, the days were accomplished, and that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Thank you.
Something we hope all of us would have within our hearts and in our lives.